You are welcome to Fidel Virtual School. You are welcome to the Creative Palace. What we are going to be looking at today as our case study is going to be introduction to batik. What is batik? Batik is from Indonesia, meaning Janese, which means dot. Batik is the way or a method of applying mixed paste or a boiled cassava, an alum, or a melted wax on a plain textile materials. And after putting this wax or your cassava paste to create a design, you now dip it into your dye bath. Now, what is dye bath? That is your bucket where you already made your dye and your caustic soda and your sodium sulfite. Now, let's go to types of batik. We have hand-drawn batik. We also have block printed batik. These are the two methods you can use. And these are our case study for today. And after doing your batik, what next? Are you going to leave your wax on the fabrics to go and wear it like that? No. The next thing is for you to do what we call dewaxing. You dewax your materials. You do what? You dewax your materials. What are the methods you can use? You can use ironing method or hot water method. Dewaxing is the process of removing the wax from the fabrics after the final dyeing process. After what? After the final dyeing process. Having known the little introduction to batik, the next thing now is for you to follow me to the studio where we are going to see the practical section, how batik is made on fabrics. I'm going to put you through two methods, the handwritten, the hand-printed method, and the block method. Please come to this program and you are going to enjoy it. Let's move straight to the studio now. Just follow me. Go. Good. You are welcome to the studio. You know, if you remember, we just left the classroom where we talked about batik, and now we are right there in the studio. You can now see the practical aspect of what we have just treated in the classroom. Can you please follow me? Now, what to do handwritten batik design? You use your charcoal to have your lines. Sorry, the lines can guide you. Now, what I want to do now is I want to use African motifs. This is my prepared foam. I've cut it in the shape of a pencil. It's either you use this or you use what we call tijatin. You have your wax already on fire. It's already boiling. Your wax is already boiling. This is my wax. I've already cut them into pieces and dropped them inside the pan. So you dip your foam. What you now do is, you are using hand, this free hand on your fabrics. can interchange your design. You can reduce the hotness of your wax. Let's get the last line. Since it's hand, you just use your discretion to put your design on it. There's no particular way to it. At the end of the day, the areas that is covered with your wax is going to come out in white. It's going to come out in white because you don't want your dye to penetrate that particular area. That's why you are blocking it with wax. Now, I will stop there. Let me do the last block. Let me play with it. Let me play around it. At the end of the day, you see what is going to come out. You see what is going to come out. Now, we are done with the hand written design. So I will drop my phone. The next thing for me is to remove it from the table. And push it down. Okay, let's not forget. Okay, let me go. The lines I've used my charcoal. I have to make sure I demarcate the lines. Next pattern, as I mentioned in the class, we go to using our prepared. I have my prepared design already. You can see, I have my prepared designs on my phone already. So the next thing is for you now to dip this right inside. And what you just do is, my wax is cold. Alright, good. We are through with the hand pattern, hand drawn pattern. As you can see, the next thing now I want to show you how to use your prepared pattern, the prepared foam pattern, which we are going to use. I have two patterns here. I'm going to mix them together. And for your own class now, I want to use my charcoal now to rule my line, to guide me in arranging my patterns. You can see me, I'm using charcoal. It's not pen, it's not anything but charcoal. I'm using charcoal to draw my lines, to guide me. As you can see, I'm using my charcoal. So now I will now dip my, this is my prepared melted wax. I'm putting it back on my stove and I'm dipping my design, already cut design. Dip it gently, you shake it, you bring it to the table. Can you see? You need a hot wasp. Dip. I want to pick another design, as you can see. Now, before you do that, look at the pattern, whether it's dropping on your fabrics. If not, you will not have a good outcome. Now, I want to dip now. Go again. Press gently. Gentle press. Dropping it again. I want to move my fabric up. Move it gently from the table. Yes. I want to use this spiral design. This spiral design. Careful because of the hotness of the wasp. so that it won't injure you. So. I'm done with the wasp. So this is the first stage of the next thing is to remove the melted wasp from the stove. The next thing is you off your stove. Now, before I will forget, now I'm supposed to have introduced this to you in the beginning. Now, this is your block wasp. This is your block wasp. How did we get to this stage of liquid? How did we get to this stage? The wasp come in this form, and you have your stove. As you can see, the stove, you can use your stove or hot plates with your pan. What you just need to do is cut them into pieces, drop them right inside your pan. You drop them carefully inside your pan for proper what will I call it now, to turn into liquid. So you leave it on the pan, on the stove for some few minutes to melt. Now you want to remove your fabrics from your table. You have done your design. As you can see, you have done your design right on your fabrics. You can see we did two patterns on this, the hand drawn pattern and the block pattern. We did two designs on this. The next thing is now to remove this from your table, put it aside, and you take your dye bath. I've already mixed my two colors. I have orange colors and I have navy blue. These are the two colors we are going to use in this class for this particular project. Now, if you remember, I mentioned two chemicals that we are going to use that are very essential for our dyeing process. Number one, you need sulfite. Number two, you need sodium. Number one, you need sulfite. Number two, you need sodium. Sodium, sulfite, and sulfate, these are the two. I've mixed them already. As you can see, you need a turning stick. You need a turning stick to mix your dye properly. In this process, if you are doing batik, you don't need hot water if you are doing batik, because if you use hot water will dewax your pattern from your fabrics because of the hotness of the water. But what do you need? First of all, you just need hot water to mix your dye. After mixing your dye with hot water, you now get the cold water. You mix it with the hot water, hot dye, so that you can have the cold water to dye. Good. This is my already prepared hot water. As you can see, it's very hot. It's very hot. So I will just take a little, pour it inside my dye. I use my turning stick to turn it. Evenly so that you can have a round dye, so that this chemical will not be settled down the bucket. Yes, that is first color. Now pick the second part. You do the same thing. You take your hot water.
mixing, you need your nose mask. Put on your nose guard on. You are satisfied with your mixing. The next thing is for you to allow it to get settled. The next thing is now take this cold water now. This cold water, you drop it. You drop the cold water. Drop it. Okay. Now, the next thing for you now is to take your fabrics, drop it inside the water, inside the cold water. You soak it right there inside the cold water. Why are you soaking your fabrics? You want to remove the excess dye. Every fabric comes with factory starch, so you need to remove it with water so that your dye can penetrate through your fabrics. You squeeze out the water. Squeeze out the water. Drop it on your table. Now, next thing is I will fold. I want to fold my fabrics. Fold it into two. This way. This is what I want to do now. Yes. I want to do my dyeing now. So I will go for my hand gloves so that the chemicals do not damage my hand. Right, the way I want to go this way, I'm doing my dipping, as you can see. Right away, I'm doing my dipping. I'm doing my dipping. Go to the second color. I want to do my dipping also. So allow that. Allow it to soak for some minutes. So you can see that there is difference between batik and tie and dye. You use hot water for tie and dye while you use cold water for batik. Go back again. If you're not satisfied, you can go back, dip it. Go back. Good. The next thing is to drop it on the floor for what we call oxidation process. I'll now drop it on the floor. I will allow you to oxidate. I'll allow you to oxidate. You won't get the color now until the final process has taken place.
allow the color to come out for some few minutes, probably like 10 minutes. And later, you allow it to get dried and you do your pasta. Good. Welcome back to class. Having seen the practical aspect right there in the studio, I'm bringing you back to the classroom now to finally round it up and see how far we have done for this class. Now, quickly, without wasting our time, you can see on the board, I have my hand-drawn pattern made on the board. You can use any African motifs to make your hand-drawn pattern. You are free. You have the freedom to use your own style. So I have already prepared designs for you on the board. You can pick any designs from the board while you want to practice your own. Now, let me recap. I said, what? Batik is a way of applying a mixture of boiled cassava. We're not using cassava and alum now. But what we are using in this class is melted wax. Note that, wax. Melted wax, we are using it on the plain textile materials. And we dipped it right in the dye bath, as you can see, after creating our good pattern. The next thing is for us to dewask. The wasking is just a simple process. After you have done your dyeing, you allow it to get dried, you wash it gently from the tap, and you allow it to get dry. After drying, just take it to your table as if you want to iron your shirt. Very simple. That is the method of the wasking. If I want to ask you again to go and use hot water, it's a long process, but you can use ironing to just dewask your fabrics. And quickly, I will give you this simple assignment. I know many of you want to experiment with it. Just get yourself 100% cotton fabrics, either white or any other color. Get it, get your wask, get your dye and your chemical, the sodium and the sulfite. These are the two chemicals and your dye. Just give yourself a treat, experience it, show me your assignment in the next class. I want to appreciate some of you that have done your assignment in the last textile class. God bless you as you have done it. And I want you also to experience this other side of tie and dye, this batik process. Please try your hands on it. It's a cash spinning experience. You can start making money from it. Don't let this pandemic to hold you down. God bless you. See you next class.